So we had already 80% done of our trip, crossed four continents, but the longest and most challenging flight, 2,020 nautical miles ahead of us from Hawaii to California. We divided that into eight legs, each about 250 miles, 1.5 hours for flight plan and wind points. I can take 165 gallons jet A with all the extra tanks, that's 12 hours, 1 hour reserve, so I needed at least 5 to 10 knots tailwind. So when we arrived in Hilo, 1st April, the forecast was for at least 10-14 days headwinds, and only for April 30, for a couple of days, we had a good forecast of tailwinds.
Yeah, we can see the Boeing 777 just passed us below us. Oh, here we approach the big island again, but we can see it's all in the clouds.
It's the fuel truck, and we'll fill up now the tanks tomorrow.
We have here already a lot of fuel, and the other one will come in the back, but guess what, it's raining, so we have to wait.
In the climb out, coming out of Honolulu,
of Hilo,
they're forecasted, coming out at 10,000, they're forecast to be 320 at 6, 18,000, 320 at 10. Then east of there at 10,000, about the midpoint at 10,000, 230 at 10.
A straight line of flight actually means starting at 51 degrees and ending at 73 degrees heading.
So, good morning. 3:20 time to get up and get ready for the flight. 5 o'clock takeoff. So, and again, checking the weather the last time on different methods, anyhow, wind and clouds and notams and all the other information, we have everything here. Yeah, it looks good. So, driving to the airport, pitch dark night.
That's your clearance for you. Clearance from Hilo to Kilo Mike Romeo Yankee. The radar vectors to 22 north, 152 west. Then as filed, climb and maintain 15,000. Departure frequency is 119.7. Your squawk is 3776.
Hilo, traffic test on November 430, Papa Sierra, taking off runway 26, right turn, Hilo. We have a very long runway. We'll take it easy here. Yeah, a little bit longer, so all working normal. Then we take it up. Yeah, and she's flying. Take the D gear up. Fuel load. Make sure that we don't hit the outer key there in front of us. We start now. Just ride into a beautiful sunrise.
don't have to hold.
Power heading 060. And we are heading out into the Grand Bleu. 2,020 miles ahead of us.
November 9100, Delta ACS 1. And November 0560 for traffic flying 080.
080 for visual purpose here. Alright, here we get now our H7 antenna out.
So you see here, that's how it looked on flight aware. We had to make a little detour, and we chose to go around first Mauna Kea and then Mauna Loa before landing in Hilo. But actually a nice flight. Would you know if she
lied to you? Here we approach the top of Mount Mauna Kea. It's an amazing sight.
And here we go again for our landing, which has to be a smooth one. It's still pretty heavy, but just at the limit for Ento in Hilo.
Since that didn't work, so since this doesn't work, I'm now testing here different antenna solutions. I use my bag here, and we have maybe antenna longer.
First we had about six and a half meters of wire out the right window, and what we really needed was to make it long, about 4 meters to get it to 10.
Now we test the antenna setting here, set up this here, and San Francisco, this is November 430 Papa Sierra, radio check. Okay, yeah, that's again the other antenna setting. I appreciate your help, and we'll try the crossing again tomorrow with this antenna. Thanks for the job, Pascal. So, and no thumbs and all. Driving to the airport.
Here we had a good start again. Oh, here we are on the way. Actually, we have now a beautiful sunrise. Flying to the sunrise, and we'll also see the sunset later. Just made a calculation here. If we continue exactly on this, we will be short 85 gallons. That's only calculating the main tank. But, well, that is what we have in our reserve tanks. Actually, we have 90 gallons in the fills. So it will get us there. And the other thing is, of course, we have here, as predicted, some headwind. It's between 6 and 4. Here we show 4 knots headwind. Should occasionally, that should eventually turn into a tailwind. So, my calculation here. Well, now the sun is up. Beautiful. And I think they will call us in a few moments that we set up our HF radio.
1703, contact approach 1843. Secondary 5574.
Okay, primary 8843, secondary 5574, and we'll call San Francisco every hour on the hour on HF. We'll have to deploy the antenna. We just got the clearance here to low down the airplane. Really slow. As we can, okay. And yeah, now we have called San Francisco here on HF radio on 8843. And actually, they heard me very well, so not the same problem that we had yesterday. Antenna is here, Boyd flying outside, relatively stable, which is good. Oh yeah, it looks all is good. And yeah, we have started to transferring fuel. You hear? So now the next thing, set. Comes on, so. Antenna out there.
Yeah, good morning, we're approaching.
So we have the shortwave radio, we have the tanks. Now, I get my oxygen here. So I use the oximeter here, the very handy dispenser, and yep, we'll put it here around my nose.
So bad to try, we have to take off the
oceanic airspace, so we have to adjust the thing to standard setting. That means yeah, we'll climb a little bit, and we adjust it also via the standard barrel. Okay, yep. Let's go a little bit up, and the airplane is in a nice climb. By the way, you see the weather looks really nice, but we will have some clouds a little bit further on. Some of you have asked me in the past videos, how do I go to the toilet, you know, on such a long flight? Actually, I have a whole thing now, and, you know, I will not show you the whole procedure. Basically, I have to sit up a bit and put it here, and hope that it's will not be totally full until I arrive, but I think that was never a problem. I'll now make the position I put. Unfortunately, you will not be able to hear San Francisco, the reply. So I call them now on 8843. San Francisco, November 430, Papa Sierra on 8843. November 430, Papa Sierra, position 2520 north, 14700 west at 1900, flight level 130. Next. 2800 north, 14240 west, 2045. Flight position 3000 north, 13840 west. November 430 Papa Sierra. Okay, confirm. November 430 Papa Sierra. basically then she reads all these coordinates that I have here on my list back to me and confirms that she has my position report and my next position. That, yeah, I have to call her every hour on the hour and make sure they know where I am. Okay, now, actually I tried to also empty my front tank because I will need gallons, and I saw it's not coming, so I found actually that here there were two in the fuel line, so it could not transfer, so I had to lift the whole thing. So I didn't film that for you, but it was a kind of exciting. And yeah, but I think now it's coming. I can see the out. It's we are good. We are good to go. And also, I waited 3 weeks and a couple of days with no headwind actually. With see what we got today. We have now a tailwind of 20 knots. Will help us to accelerate a bit trip over. And also, when you fly only in beautiful weather, well, not always. When I'm in the clouds, actually now it opens up a bit there, but essentially we fly in the clouds. Also, we have we have emptied here the pump tank. We still have quite something, about half of it in the back, so. Yeah, we should have enough to get us to California. So here we are now over the midpoint, the point of no return. So basically from here, if anything happens, we keep going. We have now flown 6 hours and 28 minutes. They are estimating another 5 hours, yep. Be in total about 12 hours for the full flight. So I have to take this here off. And the other bottle. Oh, that's empty. Okay. This is full. Well, this is plenty for the rest of my away, more than I need. See you on. So, and we turn it on, and I should have oxygen. Oh. Basically here, squeezing a lot. Link. We have now flown 10 hours and 34 minutes already. 10 hours. We still have like an hour and 20 minutes to go. So, contact with VHF, so we can enter now the antenna here. Oh, here comes the antenna. At least on the map, we have now land in sight. So here, and as promised, we had a sunrise and now we have a sunset. It is land. Yeah, I can see land now. California.
Alaska 84, contact NorCal
Approach,
130.95.
430 Pop Sierra, NorCal Approach, Monterey Pier, weather is current altitude 3001 and stay altitude.
8000 and request lower.
Approach, this is Princeton, November 430 Papa Sierra.
November 430 Papa Sierra, NorCal Approach, Monterey altitude 3002. Say approach request and verify Sierra Monterey.
112 Charlie Whiskey Roger, we got Sierra at Monterey and
It's November 430 Papa Sierra, requesting lower.
430 Papa Sierra, descend and maintain 6000.
6000 430 Papa Sierra.
beautiful sunset. Ahead of us, the Monterey Peninsula. Made it, we made it, we made it. We did it. Longest flight, probably in my life. It was beautiful. Well, the landing has to be beautiful too. Let's see that.
Zero Papa Zero, flying 080 vector sequence. 080 vectors for sequence. You're following a jet from the east.
Okay.
080 Papa Zero. Oh,
really nice. We get a right here over Carmel Monterey. Coastline.
No, over zero Papa's here, advise, monitor. No, over zero Papa's here, join at least a 7 mile final, so do approach when they clear left.
Okay, 7 mile final for 28 left, for over zero Papa's here. And we made it!
Winstar Zero Papa Sierra, say parking.
Monterey Jet Center, advise directions please.
Winstar Zero Papa Sierra, continue down the runway. You're gonna make a left at Echo towards the end of runway 28 left. Make a left at Echo and then straight ahead to the Jet Center.
Okay.
430 Papa Sierra.
Oh, yeah.
And you are also on the video now.
Okay. Well, it's nice
a
to meet you.
Reception in Monterey.
Here well, we are. I'm Bob, by the way.
You're Bob, okay.
Nice to meet you.
All right, nice to meet you, Bob.
Good job.
Yeah, Bob.
Good job.
Yeah, Bob.
Good job.
Yeah, okay, have a nice flight.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Around the world.